We get to have sex. I just had sex. Anyways.
People ask us all the time, how's NewlyWed life going?
We have highlighted 4 experiences in our first 8 months that might help you understand how it was going.
The first one is what we call Hidden Mountain.
Hidden Mountain.
September 2nd, 2019, we got married. It was awesome. The next day, we got in our car and we drove up the 101 towards our honeymoon destination.
Mm. And watched the sunset go down to the mountains.
It was beautiful. It was perfect.
We were experiencing like the mountaintop. From now on, we don't have to stay up late at night and then drive back home. We get to have sex. I just had sex. Anyways.
I always wanted to sing that, just saying.
Yes, so it was a mountaintop experience.
Our honeymoon destination was this cute cottage beach house looking thing, and it was steps away from the ocean, and amazing friends of ours generously lent it to us for honeymoon. We woke up one morning, and we both went to the couch, sat, it was right in front of this huge window, and the sun was shining in, and we just had this heart, we were having this heart to heart. And we were realizing how much we've walked through the mountain, basically that we climbed of, okay, we're friends, we're dating, we got engaged, we got married. We got to the top of the mountain. But also in that moment, we were like, there's a whole nother mountain that we have to climb.
Yeah, I'm just excited that I have a good partner to climb those mountains with.
Oh, thanks.
Yep.
Climbing our new mountain in our marriage looks like naming the shame. It looks like naming unspoken expectations, uncovering each other's blind spots.
Number 2 is exhaustion. 3 syllables.
Sound like I was saying it. I'm excited to look back at the video because you said it and then I was like mouthing what you said. Sorry.
That's good. I call it the 10% rule, that you are just 10% more tired than you were before you got married. And for me, this means before I would get off work, I'd wanna hang out with friends, go to Starbucks, go to the gym, LA Fitness, you know, do my thing. And then recently it's been get off work and then go take a nap or play video games or just lay on the couch on my phone, scrolling through Instagram or YouTube. And that's been a lot of my exhaustion over the last 8 months.
I see like 2 halves of it. One half, we're like, okay, we're tired. And there's sometimes we just can't pinpoint why, and we're just like, all right, that's fine, leave it. And then there's another half of it where it's like super logical to be like, yeah, we're exhausted. You know why? We got married, like we're merging 2 lives together. Mm-hmm. All our friendships, our relationships have changed. Yeah. We moved into a new house, like what the heck? And then on top of that, I like that he's number in them. On top of that, it's like, who's gonna do what around the house? Are we on the same page with the budget? Like, there's so many things that, that you just wouldn't really think of.
One thing that's actually helped us with the whole exhaustion thing is to do some activities, which by the way, we do have a video talking about the 7 best activities during quarantine if you wanna go to the link above.
Number 3 is golden conversations.
There was one morning, it was a Monday morning just 3 weeks ago, that we got up and we went to the hipster part of San Diego, North Park, and got donuts. And coffee at this place called Copper Toffee, I think. And we never had those donuts before. They were literally the best things ever, homemade, like all gooey, warm, best toppings ever.
We recommend it.
So we were walking with our coffee, with our donuts, and we were talking, and we were like, what if we started a YouTube channel about our own experiences of the NewlyWed life? And we shared it with other NewlyWeds or people who are aspiring to be NewlyWeds. Having that conversation led us to do this, which is literally the YouTube channel.
I feel like these conversations are gold because they're intentional, they're purposeful, and I mean, they always happen with coffee in hand and with walks, and I think that that's probably one of my favorite things that we do together.
Yeah, I remember watching my parents as I woke up in the morning, sitting outside with their coffee drinking. I'm like, what are they talking about? And now I know, like, it's just life. And if you don't have those conversations, you're not on the same page.
Yeah.
I call it the pigtail effect. Well, I don't, I think some author did once, but it's the idea of like where you have your thoughts, your fears, your anxieties, your goals in life, and then slowly over conversations, you start articulating more what that means for your life as a couple. And that's what we've been able to do time and time again with these golden conversations.
Number 4 is paper cuts and honey. The paper cuts in our marriage are the little things that we do in a day to hurt each other. There was one night where Jake and I were sitting on the couch and and I was really trying to pour out my heart, open up, be vulnerable, like, hey, this is how I'm feeling. And he did not want anything to do with it. He was not slowing down to meet me right here. He was just like irritable and like, I just had a long day at work, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I don't care. I need you right now. So do you remember that thing?
No, I don't. It never happened.
So obviously that's an example of like a paper cut in our marriage. I was just like, dude, come on. I know you get that, but.
And then she was left with like no gas in her tank for anything else in the day, whether it be a conversation or anything else. Yeah, and then honey for us is the things, the little acts of love that you do every single day to uplift your partner. Yeah. That's like for me making Kaylee a coffee or getting her water at night before bed or any number of things, doing laundry, always thinking in your head, like what's the best way I can love my wife, Kaylee, at this time. And oftentimes those lead to the great conversations at night. Those lead to feeling good as you go to bed at night with your partner instead of the opposite where you're like, I'm just ready for this day to end because I'm annoyed at them. Too many days like that, and it's just not healthy at all for our marriage. A lot of our marriage has been just a compilation of a lot of paper cuts and a lot of honey. And we try to do a little bit more honey than paper cuts.
So I'm interested in hearing from them out of all the experiences that we've shared in your own marriage and your own relationships, which one of these encouraged you the most?
I like that question. I want to see your responses. No, that would be awesome. Yeah, post down below. We absolutely love to help newlyweds or aspiring newlyweds feel equipped. So I hope this video helps, I guess.
Well,
I guess we'll see you guys next time.
Bye. Sorry.